Hi everyone, my name is Anika and I love traveling. I've traveled all over Pakistan for like the past decade or more than that, and I've traveled with almost all the travel companies that are operating in Pakistan, and every time I went on a trip I realized that there are a lot of gaps in this industry that need to be filled, especially if you look at the travel industry from the perspective of a female traveler. So I thought, you know, why not be the change that you want to see in the world? And in March 2017, I quit my corporate job and started a travel company that's called the Mad Hatters. So it's been a roller coaster ride since then, and there's been no looking back. I'll tell you a little bit more about this company as the conversation goes on, but we have Alex here as well.
Hi, I'm Alex. I'm an American traveler and I'm behind the travel blog Lost with Purpose. Maybe you've seen me before. And I've been traveling basically nonstop for the last 3.5 years. And this is actually my 6th visit to Pakistan. And I've been north, south, east, west. I haven't been to Balochistan and Kashmir, but I've been everywhere else. I'm excited to be back in Pakistan for the 6th visit, where Anika and I are running a tour for only women up to the northern areas and also in some of the cities down south. Anika and I actually first met online. I think it was Instagram story posts or something, looking for really inspiring female travelers from countries where traditionally women don't travel so much. And Anika reached out and was like, hey, I'm kind of a boss, you should maybe interview me. And she was telling me about her solo travels throughout Pakistan and how she's starting her own tour company. And so I actually interviewed her there, and then funnily enough, later on we realized that we'd met in person in the walled city like 1 year before. Just like totally random, she came up to me and a friend while we were sitting out and having chai with someone, and then...
So actually the friend I was with at that time, he was a really big fan. I didn't really know about her blog at that time. But the friend I was with, he was like, oh, you know, these people, they're from the Lost with Purpose blog. I was like, oh, what's that? She's like, oh, come, let's follow them. I was like, what? Why do you want to follow them? He's like, no, let's go say hello to them. And so we just started walking towards them and they were having tea somewhere. So that's actually when we met the first time, but we didn't really get to know each other since we started talking online.
And then earlier this year, we decided that we were going to have this women's tour. We were starting to plan things, and Anika and I basically rode around in Gilgit-Baltistan on motorbike together for like almost a month.
More than a month. Yeah, we almost died a few times in those 2 months.
So yeah, we had a lot of time on motorbike to bond and figure things out and plan out our itinerary, and here we are. We don't hate each other yet, so things are going pretty well.
I mean, I don't know where to start, because Pakistan, generally, you don't really find many women in public spaces in Pakistan. I mean, even if you don't talk about travel and, you know, women walking on the streets, just like cycling or doing anything that requires them to, you know, go out in the public spaces, you don't really find many women who have the guts to do that. That's because our society is built in a way that we don't really give women the opportunity or the freedom to pursue hobbies or things that they want to do like that. And travel industry is like the biggest example in this case. It's a very male dominated industry. You won't really find many women tour operators or hotel or women who are running hotels or women who are doing transport business or women tour guides. So this industry is completely dominated by men. Even as travelers, men find it quite easy to travel compared to women. Women have to think of a lot of things while going for traveling compared to men.
It gets a lot more tricky
because, you know, in this industry, when this industry is completely dominated by men, you have to work with those men. And keeping this boundary, keeping this thin line and drawing this line where, I mean, for a man, it's probably very easy to do things and out of brotherhood and out of friendship and like all of that. And they get a lot of favors because of that. As a woman, I have to maintain my distance. I can't be too friendly with people. I can't go beyond a certain boundary. So that kind of also creates problems for women when they're trying to work in an industry that's not traditionally considered to be where women can work. So Alex and I have been planning this women-only tour around Pakistan for like at least a year now. And so we thought that, you know, when Pakistan is so difficult for women to travel, somebody has to create that safe space for women where women can, you know, come around and feel comfortable around other women and travel with like-minded people. And, you know, when you've traveled all over and you know the kind of problems that women face, then you know how to address those problems too. You've kind of figured out ways to go around those problems and kind of, you know, fix them. So that's why we thought that probably we can do a favor to other women by bringing them here and using our experience to make things easier for them.
Yeah, I had a lot of women coming to me via like messages or comments on my blog saying that they wanted to come to Pakistan, but they were afraid for reasons beyond just terrorism and bombing. And then when I met Anika, and it's like, I blog about female travel, she's one of the few, if only, female tour company leaders in this industry. And it was kind of like a match made in heaven. We both could relate about all the travels that come with traveling around this country solo and with other people. And so we figured we might, if anyone was well suited to run a women's tour, it was probably us. So yeah, our tour begins this Sunday, actually, on the 15th. And we're taking a group of foreign women and overseas Pakistanis up to Gilgit-Baltistan and to some of the cities in the south. We're trying to have a kind of female spin on it. It is a little bit difficult to find female guides and female experiences, but for example, we're going to like women-run cafes. We're trying to stay at more homestays where people can have a little bit of the female experience, because I don't know how it is as a local traveler, but in my personal foreigner experience, it can be difficult to meet women in Pakistan because everyone on the street is a man. Like when you're walking around on the street, men are the one talking to you. Men are the ones driving cars. Men are the ones who are educated enough to speak English with foreigners and invite you to stay in their house. And so we're kind of trying to break that barrier and help these foreign tourists have a more balanced gender experience in Pakistan.
So our first women-only tour is starting on Sunday, but this is not the only one that's going to happen. We are planning to have a lot more of such experiences next year, and we might have one or two or three, I mean, depending on how this one goes. And the response so far has been great, and people have been very encouraging. People have been very interested. People have already have been reaching out to us for signing up for next year's trips. So we'll definitely be organizing more of such tours next year. And if you want to sign up for them, you can go to our website. The links are given on the screen, and you can sign up for our upcoming tours.
Yeah. Maybe see you next year. Who knows?
We're really excited to share fantastic content with you
on all the fun topics.
Please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button below.